I realised today, Brezzy doesn't wear underwear.
Last week we caused a stir online with our Brezzy and Keane revelations. Some of you even asked if we were goading you into writing fan fiction about Kezzy. The official answer to that, of course, is maybe. Venus, 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 paper flying, news happening. Take 437. This week on The Voice of Ireland, Una tries to start a tractor. A budget helicopter takes off in the helix. Brezzy deflates. And John, your dinner's ready, come on. I am coming. It was a big week on The Voice of Ireland, and I'm sure you know why. Yes, it was the week I made my first television appearance on season 4. I'm sure you all noticed.
It's a tough task for our next artist.
Yeah, you see right there, just look down, just look down. Yeah, oh, you got me there. Yeah. Oh, whatever. Fionn covered Codeline's High Hopes this week, but Brezzy had the rest of the coaches under strict orders not to turn until the high part of the song. Or as he so eloquently put it, in the end, Una was the only coach who didn't turn, and she got very flustered when she saw Fionn's lovely jumper.
Told you, you missed it.
Look, she's raging.
Hang on.
Then Rachel said something that men the world over would love to hear from her.
I feel so excited by you.
But in the end, Fionn went with Keane, who performed a crotch-smacking ritual to celebrate.
Delighted with that.
Yeah. Rebecca Kelly and her musical family were all there and even performed a song for Catherine. Rebecca's boyfriend was there too. He just wasn't singing.
I love coffee.
Although I think he may have wanted to.
And it loves me.
You're not in the Kelly clan yet. Don't worry, boyfriend, you are not alone. Catherine also wanted to be part of the family.
Well, I want to be part of the Kelly family.
Then again, this isn't the first time Catherine tried to infiltrate a family.
I want to be part of the family.
John Bonham grabbed the coach's attention from the beginning. The former wrestler slash current video games tester got 4 turns, including one from an almost possessed Una Osborne Foden. But it was Keane who managed to secure John.
I was sort of leaning towards Keane anyway, but you had me a fight no more. So
yeah, how are you? Then Brezzy, of course, said the same thing he uttered after auditioning for Westlife. After Brezzy decided he wanted Jennifer Lawrence on his team, there was only one place left on Team Una for the last 2 contestants of the blinds. Enter Mark Joyce and Chloe Murphy.
Let's get closer tonight.
When I get to Warwick Heaven June.
Things were going good for Chloe. Mark looked like he was against the ropes. What was going to happen? This was a premature battle stage of the show.
Baby, you.
What? Seeing as it is the final week of the blinds, I want to say farewell to the top 5 things we're going to miss. Number 5, acts thanking the band.
Thank you very much, thank you very, very, very much.
Thank you.
Number 4, Keane Egan thinking he's one of Snow White's 7 dwarves.
It's home from work we go.
Number 3, coaches quizzing each other as to who sang that song.
Who sang that song?
Who sang the song? Who sang that song?
It's Adele.
It's a Bob Dylan
and
song.
Number 2, the girl who opens the door for the contestants.
Love is an open door. Love is an open door.
Number 1, me making people feel uncomfortable backstage.
You're sick of me, aren't you? Yeah. What are you eating?
I'm having steak.
Oh, the lion sleeps tonight. In the jungle, the Mayan jungle, the lion sleeps tonight. To be fair, there is no end in sight for that last one. It's battle time next week and they're going to cut the contestants in half! They're going to cut the number of contestants in half! If you want to get involved, go on to Twitter at RTEthevoice or facebook.com/thevoiceofireland. You can tweet me myself at WackyAki until the battles! I'll see you later.
to let me.